Hi class, teacher Tammy here, and I'm with Heidi Shepherd from the venue Fairbanks, and we're going to learn more about her business today. Heidi, do I have that right? Is it the venue Fairbanks?
The venue Fairbanks.
Great. Tell me what happens here in one sentence.
Venue is a place for community. We offer a full bar, a coffee shop, and an event space rental.
Excellent. And what do you feel that is remarkable and unique about the venue?
I think our space is pretty unique. A lot of people come in to venue and they say, it feels like we're not in Fairbanks. And not that that's always a compliment, but I think they mean it in a compliment in that sense. We have a very distinct atmosphere. We offer all local products. So the coffee that we serve is roasted down in Anchorage, it's Black Cup. All the beer at our bar, all the liquor at our bar is either hyperlocal from Fairbanks or from the state of Alaska.
And what does hyperlocal mean?
Made here in Fairbanks.
Excellent. Who do you feel are your competitors and why do you feel that they are your competitors?
So we're downtown, so I think most of our competitors are other downtown businesses. The Tap House is also a beer forward business, so there's some competition there. We also, we do a lot of events here like music and trivia, and that's along the lines of what Goldie's offers. So I would think they were our two main competitors.
Excellent. Let's talk about your social media properties. What are the social media platforms that you currently use?
We use Facebook and Instagram.
All right. Now, as you are working with the class and the teams in the class, what are some of the social media platforms you've thought about trying and why?
We've thought about TikTok or even just expanding how we use Instagram to include reels. We have our website is fairbanksalaska.com, which is a really great website name. And I've always thought that we could really leverage that for the business, especially where like YouTube videos are concerned. But have not attempted that yet.
What are the social media platforms that are off the table? It's like, don't even try this one.
Twitter. Yes.
Now called X, right?
Whatever.
Yes.
Whatever's happening in that area.
All right. Tell us about your social media budget, both in money and time per month.
Time, we're pretty flexible. We have somebody on staff who does a lot of our graphic design and therefore kind of bleeds into the social media marketing on some level. I myself do quite a bit of the social media marketing right now. Budget-wise, we are looking to spend probably around, something in the $100 a month. But also, I'm not super familiar other than boosting posts on Facebook, like the ways that you can spend money in social media marketing. So excited
to
learn about
that. Class will help you figure that out.
Yeah.
Right? How do you currently measure your effectiveness in social media, your return on investment? How do you know what's working and what's not? Or do you?
Well, I think the number of shares that we get is usually more indicative to me of a successful post than like likes. Also comments, I think, kind of boost what we're doing. And I think in general, when the community is engaging with our social media posts in a meaningful way, sharing it with their friends, commenting on it, as opposed to just liking it, that feels like it's working to me.
Do you have other types of marketing, like email, e-news, newsletter, things like that, even traditional marketing like radio and TV?
Yeah, we do have a radio spot. We are sponsors of a show called Fairbanks Foodies that airs on, I want to say it's KFAR on Saturdays. And we do some print advertising. So we do a print calendar every month with the different events that we host. And then we usually do some one-off calendars flyers for more specific events.
Do you collect emails and send out anything that way?
No.
successes and challenges. So Heidi, describe a success that you've had with social media.
Mm. Great question.
Maybe something went viral and you didn't expect it. Just got lots of reaction.
Honestly, the thing that comes to mind is, at the beginning of summer, we had a duck that wandered onto our patio, and he was just hanging out there, and I caught a picture of him in our front door, and I posted that picture, and it was very popular, the duck visiting venue. But nothing has gone super viral. I think we have a pretty core group of people who like what we do and they pay attention to what we're posting on social media. But I'd love to expand that.
What would a success look like for you? Besides going viral, what would success look like for you in the social media scape?
Yeah, I think, an uptick in followers. I think people starting to like resonate with our brand more. I think it is some things that, like when you say that initially, they're hard things to track, but I think like people engaging with our posts or coming in and talking to us about it, I'd be interested to learn more from your students on how, like some of the more concrete methods of tracking success on social media.
I want to take you back to, you said our brand. Tell me what your brand is in three words.
Three words.
Some adjectives.
Okay, three words. It is connectedness. It is, the word that we throw around so often is a vibe. Like people are coming here specifically for the atmosphere that we provide. And then I think a big part of our brand is local.
We talked about successes. Let's talk about challenges. And what are some of the challenges in social media for you?
Yeah, I think one of the biggest challenges is most of what goes out on social media comes from my brain onto the internet. And there's definitely hesitation there. Like, I would love to crowdsource more. Like, what is cool? Unfortunately, I don't know that. So I would love to like touch base with like what is, trending or more popular, or finding ways to like intersect that with the brand.
Well, that brings us to, we're going to talk to the students directly here. What do you hope to get from the students regarding your social media plan? Why did you say yes?
I worked with UAF students for a lot of years, and I know that they have a lot to offer. And so I just think their expertise in this area would be very, powerful for us to grow what we've started. Venue is unique in that we started as a coffee shop with an art gallery space, and we've grown into something a lot bigger than that. And we possibly grew a little bit quicker than our marketing and social media could keep up with. So, having somebody from the outside look at that holistically and help us come up with a plan for how to wrap all, the spokes of what we do into something that the social media audience wants to see would be very valuable.
Excellent. Anything else that you wanted to cover or you thought we were going to talk about today?
I don't think so. I'm excited.
All right. Thank you, Heidi, and to the venue Fairbanks for being a client.
Yeah, thank you.